Back in the 1940s, Henry Ford, legendary tinkerer and champion of the soybean, liked to whack his experimental car with an axe to show people just how strong a panel fabricated from soybean oil could be. He even built a car almost entirely from soybean products. And by the way, that car ran on corn ethanol. Now turn to the 21st century. In an ironic twist, a Japanese car company has brought heartland farmers and the auto industry together once again in a whole new way.
I'm Don Bailey. I'm a farmer. They say the taste of the beans produced in Ohio is higher in protein. They like the taste of it better. Our climate, our soils are ideal. You know, most of the reactions from the customers that come from Japan is the beauty of our state. They remark how beautiful it is and how wide open our fields are. Of course, the biggest problem is the language barrier.
Don Bailey is growing some of the best soybeans in Japan, not far from this auto plant in Marysville, Ohio. Inside the plant, some of America's most popular cars roll off the assembly line. Sounds like the global economy gone a little haywire. But Bailey is part of an imaginative trade deal that's as real as the dirt under his beans. And you're probably familiar with the name that connects the crops to the cars.
No, when Honda first came in with the motorcycle plant, you know, it was a good source of employment for folks, but I never dreamed that we would have an agricultural product exchange program with Japan through Honda.
Honda started building their cars in Marysville in 1982. That was before many people in the heartland ever noticed one on the road. And the factory's 8,000-acre location just happened to be in the heart of soybean paradise.
As Don Bailey said, a perfect place to grow premium soybeans. Just the thing to fill up empty shipping containers headed back to Japan.
We had a challenge of all of these parts coming into Ohio with the parts that we needed to build our motorcycles and our cars. But then those containers had to go back to Japan to get more parts, and Honda didn't want to send them back empty.
Everything is shipped out of this location through the Honda network to Seattle, where most of our products are loaded on the barge and then shipped direct from Seattle to different ports in Japan, whether it be Tokyo, Osaka, Tamakamai, or other locations.
Joe Hanusik helps run the Honda subsidiary, optimistically named Harmony Agricultural Products, or Happy Ohio. His explanation of how this curious foreign exchange works is well practiced. So listen closely.
Well, Ohio soybean historically is a little bit smaller, but surprisingly the cost is less. Because of the limited acres and production land available in Japan, it tends to drive the price of Japanese domestic soybeans up pretty high. So even though soybeans can be raised here in the U.S. and shipped to Japan, we can actually compete or be under cost with the domestically grown soybeans in Japan.
Don Bailey grows about 150 acres of these happy soybeans. That's part of about 33,000 acres of beans the company exports. And Bailey's one of almost 200 farmers in Ohio and southern Michigan doing the growing. That brings him some attention most heartland farmers aren't used to.
They do bring a lot of their prospective customers and the customers from Japan over to the United States. And they like to come out and visit the farm, see the crop growing in the summertime, and then harvest particularly, they like to come out and watch the harvest.
Bailey says he likes the visits. Likes to show off beans the Emperor of Japan himself has been known to munch on. A fair trade, he believes, for container loads of crankshafts, cutter pins, paints, and gas pedals. And pretty good training for 200 heartland farmers learning to navigate in the global village.
We take pride in having a good quality product that we know will have our name on basically all the way to the customer in Japan. I thought it was pretty imaginative of them and a good use of their resources.